Wisconsin. This is the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers taking on Matthew Stafford and the Los Angeles Rams.
And we come to you from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. Former Utah Ute Matt Gay to get this one started. And off we go from Lambeau. Rodgers on the return. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Veteran Green Bay quarterback Aaron Rodgers ready to go for drive number one along with the rest of this Packer offense.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks. Can make every throw from every angle with terrific mobility, and he knows how to win games, always in contention for a championship.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Rodgers gonna throw. Man open, that's Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
They should put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 43. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. So the Rams in great position here as they get things started. They'll be led out by their quarterback in his 13th NFL season now. It's Matthew Stafford.
And Matthew Stafford was taken first overall in the 2009 draft, and he certainly played like a top pick. Throughout his career, he's been one of the most prolific passers in the league, and there's no reason to believe he's going to slow down his production anytime soon. Not only that, he's also one of the tougher quarterbacks in the league as well.
After the interception, here's Stafford. And oh, right away, he lost the football. P- points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Stafford going to give to Akers on the draw. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. They had quite a hole to dig out of there on third and long. Not able to get the first, but a pretty good size run.
A really good run, but how much confidence do you have in your next play call that you can sell to the head coach? Let's go get it on fourth down. Do you really have a play you believe in, or are you just hopeful? And you got to sell it to the big man before it gets called.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and this will remain a scoreless game. He's getting ready to go again here on offense. He's probably feeling like he dodged a little bit of a bullet through the interception on the last drive and then the missed field goal, so no points.
Not only did he dodge the bullet, he can go back out there and flourish now. And I'll guarantee this, one of the leaders on the defense came off the field and told him, don't worry about it. You noticed? We got you.
Well, now they'll start 3 yards shy of midfield after that long 57-yard miss. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Now Rodgers. That's taken in by the tight end, Josiah DeGuara. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. The all-pro Von Miller there on the tackle.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
2nd and 5 now. Rodgers, throw over the middle, caught by DeGuara.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
On first down, it's Jones, and he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down. From the 24, Rodgers, he'll find Aguara complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now Rodgers. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, to me, there was no question about the intent there, and I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. To throw is Rodgers. He hauls it in. Valdez-Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling there to make the grab. And the Packers have taken the early lead. That was quite the call down around the goal line on fourth and goal.
Yeah, they fake the run, pull it out, throw it, and as a defense, I've been in that spot before, and we see it all the time. You almost have to overcommit against the run. You have to almost sell out and say, they're going to run it, go make a play. They got fooled on that one.
Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good, and that makes the score 7-0. For the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
On first down at Stafford. Now this is taken in by the tight end, Bryson Hopkins. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Van Jefferson was the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
Second and 10. Stafford now to throw. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. throw there going to be incomplete. That makes him now 0 for 2 here in the first quarter on third down conversions.
And now they'll look to their defense because they need them to step up so they don't fall further behind here in the early going.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. They juked him. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Now, you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
From the 24. Rodgers, and the Rams got him. They bring him down. A'shaun Robinson, too much to handle that time, gets the sack.
It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dump that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I can dump the ball to and get it out of my hands.
A couple of extra defensive backs in the ball game here on 3rd and 6. Working from the gun, Rodgers. That ball is caught, Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A big connection on that one, 30 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a 1st and 10. Rodgers with a give, it's Aaron Jones. Takes to midfield, but no further, just a yard there.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
From midfield, here's Rodgers. So the completion good for 7 there, and they're going to have a 3rd down. Rodgers looking to throw on 3rd and 2. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he is going to have a Packers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the 1st down.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They go back to the ground with Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less, that's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
From the 25 on second down, Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. First down, Jones. On the stop was Aaron Donald.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Yards to go on second down. Now it's Rodgers. And his throw is incomplete.
The name of the game is always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
The Packers on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and eight. Throwing is Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
So much about offense is what you call hitting the yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. They'll run it with Jones. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. I love those plays. Fourth and one. That's who wants it more this time, the offense.
Yeah, there's a lot of hooting and hollering in there, right? A lot of contact and a lot of collisions as they try and find some space. Who's going to drop their hips, gain leverage, and move the other side backwards? We saw it there for the offense getting it done.
Now Jones. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
Dylan. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal. This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put 6 on the board.
Field field goal would make it a two-score game, but they're going to go aggressive. They're going to try this thing on fourth and goal. They'll go with Jones. And he didn't get there. Knocked backwards to the two-yard line. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this Rams defense comes up with a goal line stand. And the LA offense ready for this next possession. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic, meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
From the end zone, Stafford. And Stafford's going to be taken down. That's a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
Free kick comes after the safety from the 20 as they bring the punter on to try and get some hang time here. Fielded at the 20. Here's Aaron Jones in the offense trotting back out. A good job in the passing game, decent job in the running game, but really they've been more effective through the air. We'll see if that shifts at all as this goes on.
Thus far, it feels like they're calling this game in reverse. Normally, you run to set up the pass. Here, it feels like they're passing, hoping to set up the run and be more effective later on in the game.
Yeah, you can do it both ways. We usually talk about it in the reverse, however.
No doubt about it.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 right at the 30. He'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 56 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
This is Jones, a little juke, and able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. A give to Jones, and this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. A loss on that play, and now 3rd down gets tougher, 3rd and 6.
Well, that play was over before it even got started. Thanks for nothing, huh? How about that? That sets up a very difficult 3rd down call now.
The Packers on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. To throw, it's Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he's going to have a Packers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue. continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On the counter, here's Jones. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
The Packers on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and 11. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this is caught. Mercedes Lewis with a grab. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, and they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. Back deep, Brandon Powell. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Cam Akers of the Rams offense ready to go back to work. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement. Down on the scoreboard, maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but the bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
Well, they haven't established that running game yet. The question is, will they? Now a first and 10 at the 11. From the gun, here's Stafford. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. A gain of six there on first. From the 17, here's second and four. Out of the gun, Stafford. This one to the left to Higbee. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Third and two, Stafford. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. On the return, it's Rodgers. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. Number 12 back out there, Aaron his Packer teammates set to begin their drive. He's got the lead here in the second quarter. He's thrown the touchdown, but also an interception. As a quarterback, does that interception, even though you're playing well, your team's got the lead, does that always stick in the back of your mind a little bit?
For the best ones, it just upsets them that they did that because they don't think there should be any blemishes on their record. They think that they're way better than that. So your confidence gets tested a little bit. Being able to go back out there, maybe throw another touchdown, that'll tamp that down in a big way.
Yeah, because he's looked pretty good to this point. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stopped the run.
Here's Jones again on second down. And he's going to ball his way forward to the 48.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The Packers on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 5. Rodgers now to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got him bent down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
Now on first down. Caught right side. It's Lewis. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. 3 yards the gain there. Second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Coming up on 2nd and 7. The give is to Jones, and he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Dancing to his left. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first.
Now, this is a feeling I can relate to all too well. Deflation on 3rd and short. Excellent coverage. Took away all the short routes. But the one person who wasn't accounted for, the quarterback. And he used his legs to hot foot it for a first down.
From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. Now a draw play. This is Jones. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. The defensive player of the year a season ago, Aaron Donald, the one to stop him in his tracks.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Second down, another shot for Jones. He will push his way down to about the 14. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive. play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Throwing now is Rodgers. And this is going to be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So now on fourth down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. And Crosby puts it through. And that will bump up the lead again to 12-0. So 3 points there, and they continue to build this first half lead.
Yeah, every little bit helps, and the more that you can put together drives and start controlling the tempo, controlling possession, finishing with points, the better off you're going to be.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. The return is Brandon Powell. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Matthew Stafford and the rest of the Rams offense set to take over once more. And I never played quarterback, but I'm thinking as a quarterback, you're a little bit into the game now, second quarter, you're losing, you're not playing well. Probably feels like a lot of weight on your shoulders.
Certainly does, but it's something that quarterbacks have to be used to because they're always carrying around that weight. So how do they adjust the weight? How do they make it work for them? How do they work against it? That's what we're going to find out going forward.
Yeah, he'll be trying to get all that weight off his shoulders here on this drive. Stafford on first down. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. 7 yards to pick up there. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The coverage unit out there thinking pass on third and three. Play action, Stafford. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he's on to punt for L.A. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. 47 yards on the punt that time, just 1 yard on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now Aaron Rodgers and the offense heading back onto the field. He's got to be feeling pretty good, playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm. Throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's Rodgers. And that'll be caught by St. Brown. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Now on first down and complete to Lewis over the middle. A gain of 6 there on first. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
The final shot before half for Rodgers. Sideline throw is caught by Valdez-Scantling. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. The snow certainly making conditions difficult, and it's not likely to get better anytime soon, as we turn it right back over to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Has changed since we left you at halftime. The snow still continuing to fall as we are back underway. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number three. And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
On first and 10, Stafford. He'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage, and that's exactly what he got done there.
Now a first down throw, Stafford. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Chris Barnes. And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up.
I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And that one makes this a 19-point game. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. that first down, they'll start out with Akers. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Going right back to Akers. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They've got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a toss running left, Akers. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. They're losing here in the third quarter, maybe trying to get the ball outside, bust a big play. Obviously didn't work there.
And while it didn't work, I really can't fault them for trying it. You and I have talked to the offensive coordinator, and we knew that that was a place they wanted to try and go. And sometimes you just have to stick with it, because 2-yard gains turn into 20-yard gains as the game goes along.
It's caught. Beckham. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Try and run for this with Akers. And Akers, he is not going to get there. They mark him short of the first. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on fourth and short. Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 18. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers throwing the out route incomplete. It's Lewis. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And they are going to score on the final return. Touchdown, LA. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. And you know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Rodgers on the return. And able to get this out to the 25. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They're right back out there after watching the fumble go the other way. Still in control of this game, but that needs to serve as a wake-up call because they're not in the clear yet.
No, the message should be clear that fortunes can change pretty quickly when you turn the ball over. You've got to take care of it, otherwise that lead could slip away quickly.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Adams. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers, Lewis has it, the tight end. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro linebacker. It's Von Miller. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you. And you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Akers. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Michelle. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
And not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
Well, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Now Stafford. He's got it. It's Higby. Touchdown, Rams. Tyler Higby there to make the grab. And the Rams use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. And he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And And this is back to a five-point game. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away.
This fielded right at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 23. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure.
And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Von Miller showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of four. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers. Now he's flushed out left. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Short, brought down at the 45. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
The Packers punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. LA set to take over again on offense. things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. Do they want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. They'll go again here with Akers. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. They'll try the air now with Stafford. Over the middle to Beckham. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. Only needing 2 yards on 2nd down. To throw is Stafford. And incomplete. Bryson Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it's 3rd and short. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4 down territory, though, if they're stopped. On the handoff, it's Akers. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. The defense stiffens to force 4th down following that 1st down gain of 8.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on for the 5th time here today. And a fake here, direct snap to the up man. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool this defense. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. Aaron Rodgers, he's getting ready to go again here on offense. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now there's probably a silent camaraderie that comes around him saying, hey, guess what? We got you. Don't worry about it. Let's go, big fella. Because they know, more times than not, he tends to pick things up, and they tend to play well.
77 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the 3rd quarter. What you're trying to do
is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
Going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down, Rodgers. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting his inside the 25.
What may seem a little unorthodox to some people, got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
Now, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And he hits his target, the tight end Lewis. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried the dump off, lost yardage. On second down, it's Jones. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
The Packers on third down. They've converted 6 times and could use a 7th here. This time it's 3rd and 3. Again, it's Jones. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 3. He got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the first down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. The kick by Crosby is good, and that'll push the lead up to 8. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a 1-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
To the main field goal. Now Crosby will do the kickoff duties.
Taken at the goal line.
And he returns this to the 22. LA readies for its next possession.
And remember, despite giving up the field goal, this is still a one-score game. They're in need of the touchdown and a two-point conversion. A field goal on this drive likely doesn't do them much good. First down, Stafford here. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. The safety, Adrian Amos, comes crashing in for the sack. These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
Need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Stafford. Throw right side, going to be caught by Higbee. And he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The Rams on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is going to be third and 13. Now it's Stafford. Looking underneath, he's got Akers. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on to punt for L.A. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. That'll be a 49-yard punt, 6 yards there on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's Aaron Jones in the offense trotting back out. And in the early going, the running game, as we see the numbers, it just wasn't on point. Well, now it's gotten more true to form.
And sometimes it takes a little while for an offensive line to get in sync because early in a game, defenses throw different patterns at you, different formations, different sets, and you might not block them quite the way you want to, but as you start to get into a groove and you figure out what they're doing, now it all comes together, and that's what we're seeing right now.
They'll start out on the ground with Jones, and this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
First down carry by Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game. Or you can come right back and continue to run the football because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Second and 6. Here's
Here's Rodgers to throw. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 30.
These guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Caught on the right side by Jones. Not much there, only a yard.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles where he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
They go back to the ground with Jones. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
And defensively, going with a dime set, 6 DBs on 3rd and 4. Now Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
That's a play to take note of there for the defense. I think in the future, if you're going to try and block him, maybe you get a guard to help double team him and try and steer him out of the play. They should have done it on that snap.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Slant to Adams. And the Packers are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on 1st and 2nd downs. And they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Jones. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. A no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. So stuck from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
On 2nd and goal, Rodgers got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. The 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Packers add on to their lead. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a 2-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now, win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a half percent or something. It's just 2 scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far throughout.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And the lead is up to 15 now. A pretty long drive that time. 11 plays all told. And the result, a Green Bay score. the touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. Oh, the return is Powell. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
On first down at Stafford. A quick pass to Kupp. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. Now Stafford. Quickly into the hands of Beckham. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Touchdown, LA. Odell Beckham, 61 yards. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead. The electric OBJ, the short reception, and then he did the rest of the work himself.
You know, there's a thing that the players always talk about, the coaches in the league, they call it play speed. Because, you know, we have that time speed when we're running the 40s at the combine and, you know, in pro days and all of that. But play speed is different. And OBJ's play speed is some of the best in the league. In other words, when he has the ball in his hands or he's running a route, he runs it just a little bit harder than most people. And oftentimes, you come up wrong on your angles trying to tackle it.
Extra point by Gay is up and good as this gets him back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, I mean, by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
When we see another great performance like this out of Aaron Rodgers, you have to chuckle thinking that his only FBS offer was a walk-on at Illinois.
And now he's the pride of Butte Junior College, of course at Cal. And I remember watching him play at Cal, and he would run 7-on-7 drills, angry if the ball ever hit the ground, and it didn't do it very often.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And that'll be caught. It's St. Brown. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They'll run on first down. Jones. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. They'll go again to Jones. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10 on first down. Jones, and they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Take a knee. Second and 11. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone getting the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach, he's in big trouble.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So it's all over. A Green Bay victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
Partner Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.